the Red Devils, Abosamjem. See, hey, I have never seen.
Do I get to say something about United?
Please, no. You can say whatever you want.
He gets to
speak about Man United.
Yes.
You see, I was telling Daniel earlier today. Uh-huh. He said, Christopher Nimi called me yesterday and today to complain about what he called my obsession with Manchester United in the last 3 days.
Legit question.
Because his key claims have been going on and on and on. But you see, the truth, and Daniel said, is not necessary. The players aren't coming, not necessarily because they don't, or United has lost value or any of those things. Mm-hmm. But I think that's actually the truth. Because the truth of the matter is that Manchester United, as it stands now, is still a very powerful football club. But they are a very mediocre team.
Oh, yeah, sure, dear. Powerful.
Very powerful football club.
There's a difference between having value in terms of money, or in terms of wealth and assets.
Did you listen to my whole statement?
I don't think
I said Man United are still very well a powerful football club, but they are a very mediocre team.
Yeah, I won't agree with you. They're a powerful club, they are not.
They are a powerful club.
Even Arsenal get to attend G14 meetings. What are you talking about?
United are still a powerful club.
Technical.
Yes. Historically.
Practically, now they are not.
Value-wise, prestige-wise, they're still there. Unfortunately for them, at this point in time,
prestige, Papa Bain,
as a team, Manchester United, as a team, Man United, at this point in time, are going through what I call a purgatory. Period. Now, I think the team has reached a stage where they have to accept, stop being in denial, and accept that the team needs to reconstruct. This team, as it stands now, Manchester United is no longer in the position to attract the best foreign talent. And don't tell me all you want about the fact that Dybala probably rejected United, or United opted out of the deal because of his outrageous demands and all of that. If United were as powerful as they used to be, do you really think, here's the question, do you really think that if it was Real Madrid or Barcelona who were interested in Paulo Dybala, in the same circumstances, Dybala's wages would be what would prevent him from going to Barcelona?
You need to understand a certain thing. Most South American players are drawn to playing for Real Madrid and Barcelona. Yes. It's a cultural thing.
But you see...
You can't look at that and say, United...
No. You see, the point I'm making is this. Dybala is literally being pushed out of Juventus.
Juventus don't want Dybala
anymore.
That's
the point.
That's the truth of the issue.
Don't deceive yourself. They don't want him.
Yeah, nobody is doubting that.
Yes. If your parent club doesn't want you, and United were a powerful football club, it would have presented a very fantastic opportunity.
You miss a point. The fundamental hitch in this is the movement of Dybala to another club is not reliant on his parent club Juventus. It is reliant on personal dealings between him and his other agents.
And I just explained.
Yeah, that is club don't want to be fleeced.
Yeah, no, but that's...
There's a 40 million pound...
What power has that got to do with
his agents? There's a 40 million pound headache
but hold
for
on.
Either United or Spurs to take care of.
I'm...